What's up, you guys? Rowan from Radical Electric Bikes here with you again today. We're going to be reviewing an electric folding bike today. It's a fat tire and it's called the Sidekick Fat, made by a company called Alter Ego E-Bikes in Abbotsford, BC. This bike you can find at Joe E-Cycles on 786 Denman Street in Vancouver, BC, just off of Georgia Street. There's a lot of bike rental shops, but this one's just a little bit up the street there, so you can't miss it. But yeah, so this is a folding fat tire bike. I haven't reviewed one of these yet, but I have rode a few of them. And I have to say, I'm really impressed with this one because it has a patented technology for the seat post here for the battery. That's actually where it sits. So to the untrained eye, you wouldn't actually know if this was an electric bike or not. Well, unless you looked for the motor there, that is. But yeah, this you can take out as well. It's really compact. It goes down for a maximum travel range of, I think, 180 millimeters. And so it's good for riders up to 6'3". So your foot clearance down to the pedals will be good enough as well. And we'll also be diving more into the handlebars as well and how it all adjusts. So it's made for all riders, perfect for those who commute doing their 9-to-5, or if they're just doing anything else better than that. If you're just going to the beach, it's a beautiful sunny day here on the seawall in Vancouver, downtown, and great to do a review in this spot. This is actually one of my favorite spots to just hang out in general. So moving on, yeah, this bike is good for camping as well. You don't have to worry about where you can fit or not fit this in, because if it was too fat, the trail version of the Sidekick will be coming out in July this year, this summer. So it's a 2.35 inch tire instead of a 4 inch. Now that's good for those who want a little bit more speed and a bit more maneuverability in some senses. I do like the fat tires a lot myself because they just grip the road so well and even almost act as a suspension system in its own. So yeah, the frame, moving on to the frame, this is an iFOLD frame with two folding points. There's the first point right in the middle of the frame right there. You just pull it towards you. First thing you do is you unhook the safety latch and then you pull this towards you. I'm not going to do it right now just because we're keeping the bike open. And then we have another switch up at the front, which is just on the side. Now you move the lock out of the way and then you fold this down. So this will bring the whole handle down kind of into against this side of the bike on the other side and then fold in. So it'll fold up like a book, and you can even get a separate bag to travel and carry this around with you. The material of the frame is 6061 aviation grade aluminum. A lot of electric bikes and other bikes are made of this and have been for quite a long time. It's cheap enough to keep the price down. This bike is only sitting at $1,699 Canadian. So it's pretty affordable with decent parts, you know, a good Samsung lithium battery. You have an MX, I think I'm pronouncing it right, Mexus 500 watt rear hub motor. And it's throttle driven too, so it's got some features of a motorcycle in a way, but it's a thumb throttle, right? It's not a twist throttle. But yeah, it's got tons of features, a little more than what you would ask for on a folding bike. No Bluetooth speakers or anything like that. But when you're riding a bike, honestly, that's not really needed. Sure, it's cool having some tunes blasting, but you can just buy one of those separately. Over to the handlebar, we have an extra wide aluminum alloy handlebar. It's adjustable for any riders going up to 6'3" or down to 5'. So fully adjustable, anybody can ride this bike. The pedals are also foldable, so you've probably seen this on some motorcycle types of bikes. We're just going to push that in. Yeah, so that just folds inside like that. Now that's just for when you're putting it away or storing it. Obviously you need those pedals for when you're riding, so you just fold them out when you're ready to ride it again and outside. The weight of this bike is 23 kilograms, so you could store this into an area that once folded up could be, say, in a closet, above ground is what I'm saying. So very light, it's not going to break your back if you're trying to shimmy it into a particular spot. And I do recommend getting a bag for this if you are going to be doing that, or just keeping it in an area where you won't be scratching up the nice paint, because items that tend to get packed away, they could get scratched. So I do recommend getting a bag for this bike if you intend on doing that frequently. Also to mention, the weight capacity for the rider of this bike is up to 300 pounds. A lot of riders aren't going to weigh more than that, to be honest. You won't really see any other e-bikes built for anything higher than that, except for some up to about 350. But again, with the balloon tires, they act like a bit of a suspension. So if you are, you know, if you're starting out a little heavy and you want a bike with suspension, again, I would wait until summer for that. But trust me, these nylon tires, they're going to be just fine. They're puncture proof and they'll hold you up. The Mongoose tires are all-terrain tires, yeah, puncture-proof and 4-inch, so these are going to be hugging the road really nicely. The 2.35-inch, it'll probably be a sharper turn radius. You might have a kind of a bumpier ride in a way because there's not so much suspension going on like a balloon, but that's okay if you're looking for a little more maneuverability. The motor is a Maxxis 500 watt motor with a maximum speed of up to 32 kilometers an hour and has different pedal assist settings with the intelligent system. It's levels 1 to 5, and then using also the throttle that can kind of free you up a bit if you don't want to be pedaling at all, which is very nice if you're getting a little bit tuckered out. The bike isn't that heavy. It's going to be pretty easy going up the hills as long as you have that battery power. And even if you didn't, just putting it onto the lowest setting will make it a little bit easier. And again, I'll mention about that 2.35 inch tire version, which will have less drag as you're climbing up a hill and if you found yourself in that situation, which is unlikely. It's a maximum range of 50 kilometers. That's, you know, if you're on the lowest setting. And yeah, you can charge it with the regular charger. That's going to be, I think, 5.5 hours for the 3 amp hour. It's a 52 volt charger, but for another $49 you can upgrade to a charger that will charge it in 3.5 hours, which is a little bit nicer. Now the motor is capable of 75 newton meters of torque. 500 watt motors, this is why I like them, is it's a lot of power, so whenever you need it, it will deliver. It's not going to have any drag. Yeah, it's a rear hub motor, but that's to enable it so that it can have a thrum throttle. That's the fun part of the bike that some people don't care for, so that might not be a feature that you even need, but it is very good for those who are just having a relaxing time and don't want to pedal too hard. Now back into the battery, this is a hidden battery that's built into the seat post. Now it's a 48 volt Samsung 10 amp hour battery. This has a maximum range of 50 kilometers and it takes you pretty far. You can exchange that or extend that range if you just simply turn off the display. Now to turn it on, you just hold it down for a couple of seconds, and as you can see, it's on level 1, but turning it down, we're now at 0. So you don't even have to use the motor on this if you want to conserve your power going downhill, or if you just don't find yourself sweating too much and just can pedal. It really conserves it. It's a perfect travel bike. This is why I love folding bikes, is not only you can carry it on your back of the bag if you needed, but it stows away very easily into a car, an apartment, or any other small space. Now the battery also has an intelligent management system. It's basically a circuit board that prevents the battery from actually depleting all of its power. So when you're riding and it says it's completely out, the truth is it's not completely empty. It's just keeping enough charge in there to prevent the depth discharge from going too far. This can eat away and chew up the life of the battery, your range, your performance. All kinds of things can go wrong if that little motherboard, circuit board. So yeah, it's a little bit important to have those with lithium batteries. Lead acid ones, they don't need those because they're just too old. But we're not talking about lead acid. We're sticking with lithium today. And it's very lightweight. It's only like 2 kilograms, I believe. So you can put it into your backpack. You can lock this up very securely, folding it up and putting it into a garage or a shared space like that. If you literally folded the whole bike up and then locked it, it would be a real challenge to try to break this thing out. I would recommend an A-bus lock or a good U-lock made by them as well. And locking it up at certain points like where it folds, and maybe even a cable as well. So you can really spider web it up so that there's no way that anybody can take it. But if you take the seat post out, I mean, unless you know what an e-bike looks like, then you're not gonna be really targeting this thing. The display is a Kuntang LCD display. It has your speedometer, odometer, trip meter, and a USB charging port, which I thought was kind of strangely done. It's just kind of looped in, just on the side there. It could have been zap strapped, honestly, like up onto the handlebar where it would be right beside the display. I think that would just make sense, but it's okay like that if you have like longer charging wires. And well, you can set it up your light yourself if you like and put it onto this side, so depending on if you're righty or lefty. Now there's a few different ride modes. We've still got the display on. So it's on level 0 for the pedal assist, but you can flip it all the way up to 5 using the top switch, and then you switch it all the way back down, even to 0 if you're not pedaling at all. So that's a pretty decent feature like that. A lot of bikes are really made the same way. So it's a very familiar one if you've rode a few bikes already. There isn't going to be too much to get used to about it, unless you haven't tried a folding type. That's really the only thing that you'd have to work around. And for me, first time trying folding bikes, it felt kind of funny. But after, you know, just like a few minutes, you start to love it because you start to feel what it was really made for. Yeah, you're not going to be doing tricks on this or anything, but this is a perfect chill and leisure bike, commuting, as I said earlier, I believe. And yeah, just if you have shared space, perfect for that. Then there's also your throttle just right here. So that's going to bring you to the max speed of 32 kilometers an hour on a flat incline. Now, yeah, if you're going uphill a little bit, you're going to be going a bit slower, and that's where you would be wanting to pedal, because instead of putting all that onto the motor and decreasing your range, just having it on level one is really all you need. And on the first gear, the gearing is great on this bike. It was, I believe, it was a 14 by 28 tooth flywheel, so that's pretty big, but it works well with the 7-speed. This bike has a waterproof rating of IP65, so you can throw this through some mud, water, or any other weather conditions, whether it's rain or shine. You can ride around all year. I would, of course, be mindful on the snow or any types of terrain like that, or sand, so you would want to decrease the pressure of the tires a bit so that they're softer and can be a little bit grippier. But when you're on nice brick seawall, you know, pavement like this, riding around the city, this is totally fine. I mean, these tires are, they do way more than what you need them to do for terrain like this. The rear derailleur is a 7-speed tourney. This is in conjunction with the fire starter shifter up at the front, and it's very simple to use. You just use the switch with your thumb to depress and go down, and to increase you will just be going right around the front, and we'll just go down here. There is a little clicker right on the side, so that will boop it up, going up the gear 1 through 7. Now, the braking system is a 160 millimeter mechanical disc brake. They're nut brakes on the front and rear. If they were hydraulic, this would increase the price point by quite a bit. Same thing if it was like a mid-drive, right? Yeah, that would really stack it up. But this is more of a budget-built bike for those that want something affordable, that's high quality, that gets them from point A to point B. So yeah, the brakes will do a good enough job. You're only going to be going up to maybe 40 kilometers per hour on this thing. And that's not with the motor, right? That's just when you're pedaling and maybe even going downhill. So yeah, they're appropriate for the platform. So there's four different colors available. This is the black one. There's also white, blue, and red. So a nice selection of choice for color there. Yeah, you will have a front headlight as well. Haven't got into that just yet. That is controlled by going up to the display here. So we're going to turn it back on, and you'll see it turn there. Now, you just hold the front top button for about 3 seconds. Now, it's not going to actually show you on the display. That's what I noticed. You have to look and see for yourself. So that's definitely turned on. I think you can see that. Yeah, so that's on now, and I'll just turn it off, just see what it's like when it turns off. There we go. Yeah, I think that picked up on the camera. It's very bright today, so it's kind of hard to tell these things. But one thing I can't show you today is that because this is like one of their new bikes, they haven't taken off the little tags and stuff, I'm leaving it like this because, yeah, they'll be trying to sell this bike later. So the switch for this one is just right here. It's dimmable, so it's got a few selections for that. And yeah, so you're fully covered at nighttime. I would also recommend maybe an extra light or two. I mean, I do that at nighttime regardless of which bike I'm riding. Really, your safety is number one when it comes to riding anything, whether you're in a car or on a bike. Planes, trains, and automobiles, guys, be safe. And then last but not least, we have the alloy spokes. They are like spokeless. They just have like the arms inside. And this is a bike not really made for speed. So I know some of you are looking at this like, oh, this is a no-no. It's not very safe. But it is okay, as long as, you know, you're not racing with this thing and wobbling out, which isn't going to happen. You're not on four wheels. So to those who are doubting this bike for its speed capabilities, you know, you just ride safely. Anybody riding irresponsibly is going to be causing an accident or wobbling out in any way. So yeah, you mind your own business, you're chill, bring your bike back inside, fold it up, and charge it overnight. So that pretty much covers it for all the specs of the bike. We're going to move on to our test ride now. We're on the seawall just in downtown Vancouver here. It's an absolutely gorgeous day. You can see we got the bridge in the background. But yeah, we're going to be taking out not just onto these bricks and the rest of the seawall, but we'll be going onto the grass, going off of a few curbs, and really putting those spokeless wheels to the test, because I know that some people don't like that design because they worry if bearing the weight and coming down is going to damage them. Now, since it's a folding bike, I'm not going to be torturing it. We're just going to be going over very basic curbs, you know, some speed bumps, things like that, where you know, might be rolling over some objects, but that's all you want to do with this. Now, with the suspension version, when it comes out in summer, might give you a little bit more maneuverability that way, but again, this is a folding bike. It's not really made for beating up too much. So without further ado, we're going to move on with our test ride and going along our beautiful seawall. Okay, so we've got it on level one here, you guys. Just going to make sure we don't run into anybody. Okay, so it's pretty busy. I'm not going to go too fast just yet. Just gotta wait for some of this congestion to go down a little bit. Okay. So yeah, level one, we just got it actually, we'll bring it down to zero, just so I can tell you what it's like pedaling it on its own. So yeah, I'm just on the first setting. This is easy to pedal. We're just on pretty level ground, a slight incline now, but it's not too hard. I can feel how this would be a bit more tricky going uphill. Yeah, that's where you need to have the battery for these types of fat tire bikes. So let's just boot it up to level one. And right about there, yeah. So haven't increased the speed setting yet from the Shimano 7 speed, and it's reacted quite well. We're gonna just bump it up more as we go here. And once we have a little bit more of a straightaway, I'm gonna try to go a bit faster because it's a nice busy day. We've all been waiting for the beautiful sun to come back outside, and none of us seem to have a different idea. Yeah, great minds think alike. Okay. Yeah, just lightly pedaling on the first setting, just if you're cruising around, that's all that you have to do. If you were to bump it up, it's gonna be pretty more, oh yeah, I just put it up to level two. And that was enough to just, with each pedal stroke here, I'm just gonna, some people. Anyways, just gonna go over the bumps. Yeah, those balloon tires act almost like a suspension. Okay, so I'm gonna start hiking it up a gear here. We're on level four now, or speed setting four, but PAS is on level two. And oh man, I'm just letting my legs drop down and carry me around. This feels almost effortless, really. If you can kind of see what my legs are doing just like that, I'm hardly even trying. Yeah, so if you're a novice rider and you haven't tried an e-bike before, this will be just fine for you. Because it's not much to get used to. We haven't even used the throttle yet, which we will get around to doing. Okay, so we're gonna test the braking power. We're gonna start with the rear brake. Okay, that wasn't too bad. Now, I wasn't going that fast. Since they're mechanical, they don't grip like hydraulic brakes do. So here, we're just gonna start to clamp right down in 3, 2, 1. Well, that actually stops pretty nicely, as you guys can see. We're just going to take a right and go onto the seawall now. Now we got a little bit of hills here. I'm going to hike it up to its top setting. And it's going to kind of flat out again, but oh yeah. If you can see how fast I'm pedaling my legs, it doesn't take much to just take off. It can really detect when you want to go faster. And just like that. I'm gonna have to increase it a few settings to keep up with the pedaling. Yeah, like I feel like I'm not even trying to pedal this thing right now, you guys. It's pretty smooth. It's passing on your right. Passing on your left. Yeah, make sure when you guys are sharing the space with anybody that you let them know you're coming up from behind them, because if you really expect anyone to have eyes in the back of your head, well, you're smoking something. So I'm gonna start to pick up the speed here. We've got it on speed setting 7 and assist level 5. And I'm just barely trying to pedal this right now. It feels almost effortless. Now as we go up the seawall here, there's gonna be a little bit more hills. But here, let's actually just turn off all the settings. Let's bring it all the way down to zero. Now I'm just pedaling on, level 7 on the 7 speed here. Now when you're on flat ground like this, this is where you extend your range. This would be ideal for those long trips. If it's going to be really nice and flat and you just have those hills that you want to save the power for, that's what it's best for. Now we're starting to get to a little more of an incline. I'm pedaling a bit more slowly. We still don't have any assist turned on yet. But once we get up to this next bend, I think I'm going to try. Okay, yeah, right about here it's starting to get pretty tough. So we just bumped it up to the first setting. And right off the bat, yeah, it's giving me just a little bit of assist. So even on the highest gear, you can pedal this a little bit uphill. Now on the second one, it should be a little bit better. Yeah, when you have it on the 7th setting or the highest gear on the derailleur, and then you try the PAS, you can actually tell where it's picking up and dropping off much more accurately when you're test riding any type of electric bike. So when you're looking for your bike, it may not even be this one, just keep that in mind. Because you want to feel exactly what it's doing, because if you're trying to calculate how far you need to go and you don't want to run out of range, well, you'll be fine because you can still pedal this anyways. But yeah, it's a bit of a nuisance when you run out of power and you're in an area that's just completely packed with hills.
Now we've just tried the rear brake. We haven't tried doing the front yet, just because I wanted to have a little bit more space to have the clearance to do it. But we're gonna do it just on the straightaway once we pass these people here. Passing on your left. Okay, you guys, so we're gonna slam on the front brake. I'm gonna try to do my best to not do a front flip. Okay, yeah, that grips pretty nicely. So as you can tell, when you need to brake, it grips as hard as you really need it to. If it gripped too hard, maybe this is why having hydraulic brakes wasn't used for this bike, was that it's a different center of gravity, a different position that you're sitting at, even though it's quite upright. You're not really sitting in a particular position that's good enough that will prevent you from flying over the handlebars. I mean, you are more upright, but still, with a folding bike, it's the ergonomics are just different. So something to keep in mind. Okay, so we're gonna take it out onto this little trail here. So now we're on a little bit of dirt. Now I can tell you some feedback that I'm getting from the tires here is that it feels almost like nothing. Like I'm just gonna roll over that. Oh, that felt great. Let's roll over this. Yeah, this handles just fine. I was actually worried about not being able to show you guys what this can do. So we can finally do it. We found some decent roots in the ground here. So, the camera's shaking a little bit, but I'm sure the gimbal's helping. But yeah, this is very comfortable. It's almost like having a suspension. I'm pretty light. I'm only 160, 65. So bumping along, it's actually quite comfortable. Just, you know, standing up on your legs a bit. Obviously, there's no front suspension that will help you. So you kind of have to be your own suspension in a way. And so is life. You must take care of yourself. But anyways, going back onto the wall here. Oh yeah, just going right over these corners and these curbs there, these little drops, they're almost like nothing. So a couple pointers about how smooth this ride is. On these tires and also the frame, it's incredibly stable. A lot of people talk smack about folding bikes for them just, you know, like some fall apart apparently. And this is just from personal experience, so I can't speak for anybody else. But I have not come across any bike that actually falls apart yet in any of my reviews. So you will find out as you watch my videos though. if any bike does fall apart, you will see. So anyways, about the stability again, is just that this is a perfect stop and go bike. I mentioned that just in the last part. But especially just like if you're doing anything, like you can haul groceries on this. I didn't mention it yet, but there is an optional front pannier rack and a rear rack as well that you can get. Yeah, they're separate though, right? So I think they're $49 a piece. I don't know if they would charge any for like extra labor installing them because they're pretty simple parts. But yeah, so those are available to purchase separately. So one thing about the mechanical disc brakes that I've noticed is they do scrape a little bit. You know, it's basically metal on metal almost, well, except for the pad, of course. But yeah, it's not gonna be super smooth and quiet like you would with your hydraulic. So yeah, just refer to, yeah, earlier in the video, I've been discussing what you should do if you want that. You just buy a different one. Now I'm trying to imagine what the handling would feel like on the 2.35 inch tire. But yeah, it would just be tighter. Just going along turns, it would feel just a little bit softer, or not softer, just yeah, a little more stiff. And this is why I prefer fat tires though, is it's everything about it is just so laid back. You can go fast when you need to, and I haven't broken a single sweat riding this bike at all today. We've got perfect weather as well, that counts. It's not that hot outside. I'm only wearing a t-shirt, so yeah, just dress appropriately, since folding bikes feel sometimes a little awkward to operate at first. But once you get used to it, it's just like learning how to ride a bike again. You never forget. Okay, you guys, so we're just gonna ride over the grass and test what it's like going over bumps and some uneven terrain. We've got a pretty hilly environment, so we're just gonna be climbing up and down in combination mostly with the pedals, but also with the throttle, because we want to see exactly how much you can rip around on these fat tires in a nice open area like this and just have some fun. So we're just going to avoid our geesey friends here. Okay, so let's rip it. We're just gonna go right across this pavement here. So I'm just pedaling it on level one right now. It's not getting tons of assist. Yeah, just rolling on this grass, it almost feels the same as riding on the road. Of course, you feel a bit of bumps going on, but that's to be expected. Okay, now I'm gonna turn it all the way up to level three. Yeah, significant difference in how much it helps me. Yeah, going over these dips and turns, really good on these fat tires. Little duck families everywhere. Okay, so yeah, on pedal assist setting three, it takes you off just like almost effortlessly. You just have to let your foot and your leg drop down and it just picks you up from there. It can detect exactly how you're trying to pedal. So let's just try to give it some throttle now. Just gonna keep ripping it around like this. Oh yeah, still picking up speed, I can tell. Just went over a bunch of roots there. Wow, this handles so well. Let's just keep going here. Let's just go underneath this tree. Got it. So yeah, you can maneuver around on this thing. Just gonna play around in the parking lot a bit here now. Yeah, just transferring from one terrain to the other feels great on this. It's very smooth. The rolling is quite like it's gradual. It's not like hard and like the feedback, like because there's no suspension in this, you would normally be getting some pretty tight response. But no, I just press the brakes and those grip very well as well. Just waiting for a clearance here. All right, let's just keep going. Just gonna keep it on the throttle. Oh yeah, this is great. Making under this tree. Nice. So as you can tell, even though there's no suspension, this is holding its own very well. So we're definitely going faster than 32 now. This is what I was talking about. I mean, going downhill on just about any bike, you're gonna go faster than 32, but yeah, so the bike can handle the speed. That's basically what I'm saying. It's not gonna wobble out or feel weird if you tried to do anything too hard on it. So we're just gonna take a tighter turn here. Oh yeah, that handles so well. With the fat tires, you can just roll from side to side. This is a very comfortable folding bike. I already mentioned people talk smack about this kind of thing. So as you can see, there's kids popping out everywhere here, and I'm just pressing on the brakes just as I need to, not slamming on them or anything. But they work very well. So like, I think if these had hydraulic brakes on it, since you got a bit of a higher center of gravity, you could be thrown off the bike if you gripped it too hard. So I actually like the mechanical disc brakes in this case. I like having my stopping power and all that energy, but this is good enough. This, yeah, as I said before, keeps price point down. And yeah, $16.99, it's a pretty good price for a bike like this. So just to mention, for those that want that bike with the suspension, with the smaller tires that'll be coming out in summer, I would recommend it if you see yourself going off of, say, like you see the side of the curbs here. I'm not gonna do that because, the one thing that I just don't trust enough about this bike is taking big drops. Full spoked wheels, that's why you would want to have full spokes for taking those bigger dives and jumps, because you just have more weight spread over multiple arms, more arms than are on this. If I actually just count here, I think this is we're just gonna slow down and count for one sec. This was 1, 2, 3, it's only a 5-spoke or 5-arm wheel. So yeah, I get why some people, you're still watching this, might be like, what is this guy talking about? When it comes to this is being safe. Well, it's a folding bike. If you ride it like a folding bike, it will be safe. But if you ride it like a mountain bike, you'll probably have some problems. Okay, so we're just gonna rip it on the throttle a bit here. We're just gonna keep twisting and turning. Yeah, this thing is just ripping it. This is a blast. We're just back on the wall here. Yeah, taking this out on the grass, this is so much fun. People on the seawall are going slower than me. That's no problem. I'll just create my own road. So the maneuvering around corners on this bike is just great. Some people, they'll want those skinnier tires for better handling, but I like how they hug the road. Like if you can kind of see down there, yeah, you can like go wide, you can go left, right? And it's just going to be completely rounded. Like it'll hug the road. This is what you see with, you know, when they're doing motorcycle racing, is they lean over as much as they can and kind of push off of the ground with their knee as they're riding, because those wheels give them the ability to grip the road while almost being absolutely horizontal. Of course, you won't be pulling off those types of maneuvers on this bike, but that's what's so great about wider tires, is they literally hug the road.
Okay, you guys, so that concludes our test ride and review of the Sidekick Fat by Alter Ego E-Bikes. I would like to thank Jay at Joe E-Cycles for giving this to me to test ride for today. It was super comfortable with the 500 watt rear motor and with the throttle too. It's a lot of fun. And pedaling, I still can't get over how on the lowest setting and then combining speed gearing one with pedal assist level five, it takes off underneath your feet. You literally feel like you're going to fly. That's not a sales pitch. That is actually how it feels. I just could have put some wings on it. Maybe it would have worked. Who knows? But it was super comfortable. The maneuvering was great. The handlebar was very comfortable and very nice, comfortable upright seating position. Good leg pedal distance to my foot. Actually, I did say how it was a little short, so that was just my fault for not raising it a little bit more. But I'm about 6 feet tall, so it worked out just fine. I was able to kick it out to its maximum speed very easily. And it actually keeps you down like that way too, so it's the safe speed limit of 32 kilometers an hour. You could go faster downhill, but when you're, as you noticed in the test ride, on a flat surface or going a little bit uphill, you are not going to be going above 32. It's going to keep you at that rate. So it's a very intelligent bike. Comes with the lights, so you're safe for nighttime, front and rear. And I know that we couldn't really show you how it looked on the rear because we have this little plastic tab here, but I'm keeping it nice for Joe E-Cycles, because they're still going to sell this bike to the lucky person who will want to take it. Again, it comes with the fenders, but I don't think I mentioned this yet, is the rear and front pannier racks. You can purchase them separately, and I'll just leave links in the description of this video so you know where to find everything. But yeah, that pretty much covers it for this bike. It's perfect for commuting. If you share some space or have roommates and need to fold this up and charge it up overnight to go to work or go to a party or whatever, just make sure you bring your lock with you and fold it up nice and good and take out the seat, because the battery is in the seat post. So I do recommend just always doing that with you. Don't leave it around. Even though to the untrained eye, they might not know, a thief might not know it's electric. All it takes is just to look at it for a few seconds longer if they're smart, and they'll basically figure it out. But the brakes were great. They are just mechanical, as I mentioned before, but they're fine for what this bike performs for its purpose. So that wraps it up. Thank you again for watching Radical Electric Bike's review of the Sidekick Fat. We will have more reviews coming up once per week. That is my target goal for posting videos up, because I want to keep showing you guys some awesome radical content, guides, reviews, and adventures. So like, share, and subscribe if you like this video, and you'll be up to date with all those reviews to come. So again, Rowan from Radical Electric Bikes, thank you very much. We will see you in the next review, and ride safe.